A very good morning to all of you, my dear students. Welcome back to the class once again. Hope you are all fine by the grace of Almighty. So we are going to discuss in the chapter federalism. Our next topic is about center state relations, relationship between the state as well as the center. So let us see what are the relations or what were the relations also. So we have to begin from the past as well. So we can see that from long time, the same party means I want to say about Congress party in India, the same party was ruling at the center as well as in most of the state. Most of the states, I'm saying, I'm not saying that in every state Congress was ruling, but in most of the states of India, Congress was having or ruling, you can say, and even at the center also. So if the ruling party will be in the center, thus who is in the center and as well as the state will be same, then what is going to happen if the parties will be same from both the side, from in the central government also and even at the state government, both party will be same, then what can happen? Let us see. This meant that the state government did not exercise their rights as independent federal units. Yes, that is quite significant, or you can say that is quite clear, and that is going to happen. If center will be there, if the party at the center and the state government will be same, then the state government, whatever they have the power, you know, as a state government, which they have got from the constitution, they would not be exercise their rights or powers as a independent unit, because they have to, because they are from the same party. So they will have to listen to the center only. Whatever the instruction they will receive from the center government, that is central government, the state government, as it is the same party, then they will have to do only that only. So we can say that the state government will lose all their powers if the center and the central government and the state government will have the same party ruling. So that is one of the disadvantages also. When, as you can see, it is clearly mentioned in your book also, that as and when the ruling party at the state level was different, the parties that rule at the center tried to undermine or weaken the power of the states. Now there is another question, that is the reverse side of that particular thing is also that central and state government will be same. Then there is a reverse side also. If they are different, when the as and when the ruling party at the state level was different, then what the party who is at the center, they try to undermine or weaken the power of the states. They try to weaken or they try to dominate the central government. As we know that in India, we are having holding together federation. And in this type of federation, what is there? That the central government usually has more power. As we have seen in union list and state list as well as concurrent list. So in union list, what we have seen, the state government will make final decisions. And what we have seen in concurrent list, that state government will also dominate, central government will also dominate there. If there is a conflict, then in the concurrent list, then again, the central government will have the final decision. So even in union list, as well as concurrent list, we have seen, and even in residuary list also, the central government has to make the final decision. So in above, total of four different type of lists, three of the lists are under the control of the central government. So we can prove it that the central government in India has more power than the state government. And that is also the reason the central government try to undermine, or you can say weaken, the power of the states by dominating, as they have more power. So that is, we can say that is a disadvantage when there is a different government also at the center as well in the center and the state. In 1990, so there was a huge drastic change, you can say, in India from 1990 or in 1990. There was a rise of regional political parties in many states of the country. Regional means local political parties in the states of the country. So a lot of parties started rising, or just people were creating different type of parties. Like we have different type of parties in India now. There are many parties, you know. Aam Aadmi Party is there. Even Congress Party was from the beginning, and even BJP Party is also there. So a lot of parties started rising from the year 1990 from the local government and from the local places. That was the beginning. This was also the beginning of the era of coalition government as the center, because the central government was not able to gain enough seats to rule by majority. So what happened next? If they were unable to rule by majority, then a lot of different smaller parties will merge together and they will form one government, and that would be known as coalition government at the center. So in the year 1990, there was a change and there was a time of coalition government, and it was there for a long time. So from 1990, we can say there was a beginning of the era of the coalition government. So there is a meaning also. I have got it for you people. The meaning or the sentence what you have to write about the coalition government, you can see: a government formed by the coming together of at least two political parties. If two political parties come together and they form a government, because none of the party were not able to gain enough seat to rule by majority. So what happened if they are not able to gain that enough seat to rule all alone, then they will have to merge with other parties. That is known as coalition government. Usually partners in a coalition form a political alliance, that is agreement, political agreement. They do a political agreement, or you can say understanding, and they adopt a common program also. A common program which they both agree, and they used to adopt such programs also. Only you can say they adopt only such programs which is common among them, which is not harming any one of the party. So that is the one of the greatest feature of a coalition government. And let me tell you that people get a lot of benefit. Citizen of the country get a lot of benefit when there is a coalition government. So a government formed by coming together of at least two political parties, that is coalition government. Hope you all understand all these points. So a new culture of power sharing and respect for the independence of state government began from 1990. Now the state government were free, and now they can exercise their rights or the powers which are mentioned in the constitution of our country. So there was a new culture of sharing of the power as well as respect. Now the central government was respecting, or even they were sharing their powers, the central government sharing their powers also, even respecting the state government from the year 1990. That's why we can say over here that was the beginning of a new era in Indian politics also, the 1990. Because before that, when there was Congress everywhere, even at the center as well as the state government also, so there was no such thing that state government could exercise their rights as independent federal units, as independent units, because the central government was just dominating the state government as they were having the same party there. So whatever the central government was giving instruction, the state government was following. But now the things have changed from 1990. The things have changed. The state government can oppose related to any decision of the central government also, as they have the power. So if there is a conflict or issue, they can. And even the central government was forced, or you can say they were helpless, as they were forming coalition government. So they have to respect also and share their power with the state government as well. So that was really a new culture of power sharing and respect came into being from 1990 also. So you can see from year 1990, an era of coalition government started, and even an era of new, or you can say a new era of culture of power sharing as well as respect also started from there. Now, you can say that was the last thing that just finalized this particular thing, that a new culture of sharing power was really finished up by saying from the Supreme Court also. It was supported by a major judgment of the Supreme Court, which made it quite difficult for the central government to dismiss state government in an arbitrary manner. That is, arbitrary means illogical manner, or in a sudden manner, or in an uninformed manner also. The central government can't dismiss the state government in a hurry or in an illogical way. You can say in an arbitrary manner. So that was the greatest judgment in the history of India that really made it difficult for the central government to dismiss the state government illogically or in an uninformed manner or in a sudden way. So that was really a good thing for the state government also, and Supreme Court helped them a lot in that case. So we can say finally about the relationship between central and state government that federal power sharing now is more effective than it was earlier when there was the same government in the center as well as the state. So federal power sharing is now more effective today than it was in the early years of the constitution when it started or when it was adopted by the government of India. So nowadays we can see that there are different government at your state and at the central level. It means what? That the state government can exercise their rights, can use their powers, and can take their own decisions also in certain matters. They don't have to just beg to the central government for everything. They are free because they have got certain powers from the Constitution of India, such as they can take any decision related to whatever the subjects have been mentioned in the state list. They can take decisions. No one is going to stop them. But when there was same power at the central as well as the state government, even the state list, even the subjects which are there in the state list was under the control of the central government also. When there was a same government or same party ruling at the state as well as the central level. So there was no use of, at that time, there was no use of that state list or the subjects which are mentioned in the state list. Hope you all understand about this central and state relationship that was in India and now India also. Okay, then after state relationship, we have to go through understand about decentralization in India. What it really means, decentralization in India, let us see. And how it really started. And what was the need of decentralization in India? We will have to go through. We will have to understand. Let us see. States in India, nowadays you can see, or even before, you will just have funny things over here, that states in India are as large as independent countries of Europe. Many of the Indian countries of Europe are as large as of many of the states in India only. So I mean to say over here, that India is so large that many of the countries of Europe, according to the sizes, if you will compare with the sizes of the states of India and the countries of Europe, then it will match. There are a lot of examples. Let me say that in terms of population also, now we are going to term in terms of population, Uttar Pradesh is bigger than Russia. It means Uttar Pradesh is having more population than Russia. The whole Russia is a country. Maharashtra is about as big as Germany. The whole population of Germany almost matches with the population of Maharashtra. So you can see India is so large. I want to point over here about the diversity that we are having in our country. You can read it over there. Many of these states are internally very diverse. They are quite diverse. Means a lot of different type of people having different type of faith, even culture, practicing different religions, speaking different languages and enjoying different festivals also. So there is a great diversity in our country. And many of the states of our country internally have a very diverse population. Means even house to house, it will change. House to house, language, and even you can see that religion or the customs and the culture practices, everything can be changed from house to house in the same area. That I mean to say over here, that internally it is quite diverse. There is a great diversity internally. And the great example of the great diversity in India is Maharashtra, where people of different faith, religion, culture, custom, caste are living all together. Where you will find house to house, there is a change. So there was a need of power sharing within these states, such as Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, and many other states also. So there is a need of what? Power sharing. People or the citizen of those powers should have power in, should have, and people of or citizen of that particular state should have power, which is given by the constitution of our country. So they must be able, they must be able, or they would be able to share or use those powers also. Means powers written in the papers only will not work. They must be implemented also. They would should be able to use those power also. So there was a time. Now let us see. Federal power sharing in India needs another tier of government. So because of this diversity, because of this, you can say great or huge diversity internally where it was there in their many states. So their feel, the people of India, the citizen or the lawmakers, or the government of India who were at the central also, they felt the need of another tier of government, means another level of government below that of the state government, which really can look into the affairs of the people, problems or issues of the people at the base level. Means they can move to the people directly, they can talk, they can interfere with them, and they know about their problems. So there was a need, and they felt that there is another level of government needed in our country, which is known as another tier of government also. So there, from there comes the decentralization of power. Foundation of decentralization of power just came into being, which resulted in the third tier of government in our country, that is known as local government, or we can sometimes say as panchayati government also, panchayati level, government at panchayat level. So there comes the need of another tier of government, and there comes the need of, or you can say the foundation stone has been laid for the decentralization of power. Now, if someone asks about the definition of decentralization, then the red lines are there for you. When power is taken away from the central and the state government. Now, the power taken away means reduced from the central as well as the state government. And those power which have been taken away, those powers are given to the local government, which is known as decentralization. Means will central government will not directly interfere into the affairs or into the working of the local government. That is the decentralization. And not only the central as well as the state government will also not interfere, just they will guide, they will provide guidance to the local government. So that is known as decentralization. Means a lot of power is taken away from the central as well as the state government, and those power are given to the local government, which we are going to discuss in this chapter only. What are the powers given to the local government by taking away from the central and the state government? We are going to discuss about them. Hope you all understand till here, I think. So let us see to the next topic, my dear students. What is their needs or advantages? And a question may be there in board exam. If the examiner asked you about the right, what was the need of decentralization? Or in other words, you can say this is the advantages of decentralization in India. Now, what were those advantages or what was the need? Let us see. The basic idea behind decentralization is that there are a larger number of problems as well as issues, which can be best settled at the local level. Sometime when there is a fight between two people, even the local police station, they also request both the parties to settle the problem at the local level. If they can't settle, then the police station involves and they used to solve the problems also, and they bring it in the light of the court also. But people used to ask others that please solve your problems and issues at the local level. So the basic idea behind decentralization in India was that so that the problems and the issues which are in great number, which can be solved at the local level. So as you can see that different schools have settled or started different WhatsApp groups also for the student, so that the problems and the issues of the students can be solved then and there in the groups. It should not come in a very big manner to the management. So they used to start many WhatsApp groups also for the help of the solving the problems and issues of the students also. So that is a type of help at the local level, at the root level, you can say. So the same idea was behind decentralization, giving power to the local government so that they can solve the problems and the issues of the people living in that particular local area. So as they have better knowledge of problems in their localities, and that is the reason, that was the need of giving the need of decentralization, or there was a need of rising or creating one more tier of government. They also have better ideas, you know, on where to spend money and how to manage things more efficiently, such as if they want to just sink one or two hand pump or 10 hand pumps, 20 hand pumps in a village, then the people of the village know it better that where it should be sink, you know, कहां पर लगाना चाहिए वो हैंड पंप, वहां के लोग ज्यादा अच्छे से बताएंगे. सो द पीपल कैन सॉल्व देयर प्रॉब्लम्स फ्रॉम देयर लेवल एंड द लोकल लेवल मोर एफिशिएंटली एज दे हैव बेटर आइडियाज वे टू स्पेंड द मनी फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट. Local level, it is also possible for the people to directly participate even in decision making. They have Gram Sabha, Gram Panchayat, Panchayat Samiti, Zila Parishad, all these are there, which we are going to discuss in the later part of the chapter. So people at the level, at the very directly, they can involve in making a particular or taking a particular decision, which help, or you can say in conculcate a habit of what? Democratic participation. So forming a democratic country and maintaining its democracy, there was a need of, or advantage you can say, there was a need of third tier of government, that is the local government also, which also you can say decentralization was there in India. Even local government is the best way to realize one important principle of democracy, that is local self-government. So decentralization over here is helping the people of India, citizens of India, to exercise or use their own power by having their self-government. So local government, we can replace the word local government from the self-government also, as people have a lot of authorities and advantages as the state government as well as the central government used to give a lot of power to them. So power to use how to spend the money or to realize this money and how to make a particular decision, people used to get participate and get opportunity to participate in decision making also. That is all in this class, my dear students. Hope you all like the class. We shall meet again in another next class. That's all. Stay at home and stay safe, my dear students. Bye bye. Take care. Thank you all.